Hey, pilots! Welcome to another exciting episode of War Robots Domination, a series of helpful gameplay tutorials designed to help highlight the tactics and strategies that I use to help tip the scales in my favorite game, War Robots. Each episode will feature a handful of battles along with helpful commentary that'll provide insight as to what I'm doing and why I'm doing it. I'm your host, Gotcha Beacons, and I've been playing this awesome game for a few years now, and I've learned a few tricks along the way that I'd love to share with y'all. You'll notice that although my hangar is fairly basic and at lower levels, I have been able to climb it up to Expert League, so I believe that you'll find my tactics will help you do more with less, which could be very helpful with today's economy in the game. I should also mention that this is my second account, so don't let my career profile stats fool you. This is actually my baby account, but it sends a great message to pilots who feel they need to chase the current meta in order to be competitive in battle, because you don't. Wise gameplay can usually overcome any fancy gimmick. A death button is a great example. It can still melt just about any build, and its heritage stems all the way back to near the beginning of the game. It's all about knowing when to use it and how to use it. So, without further ado, I invite you to sit back, relax, and enjoy today's episodes while I walk you through my gameplay tactics and share with you my mindset in battle. I hope you find it entertaining, helpful, and fun to watch. I think you will. I'm going to call this battle Tactical Timing, guys, and you're definitely going to want to stick around and just kind of learn some things here. Enjoy my friends in the background and Status as they play their awesome song, Theta. All right, guys, so this is a Springfield. I open up with my open map deck. This is Major Payne. He's my beautiful Zeus Fury. I always open up with him on this range map because I can get a line of sight to the center beacon. I can keep a guard on my right beacon and my left beacon and see what's going on. Now, hopefully, my men are all going to spread out and press forward and go to the left to get that one up on the platform and then cross over the bridges to get the one on the far left. And then maybe one guy goes up in the right there in the silos and kind of monitors that, maybe gets in close. And basically we have a containment zone where all they have access to is the center field beacon and the one back in the dam. So, you know, that gives them two beacons. We've got three beacons, and that's how you win. Well, no one was really pressing that hard. So, you know what? I don't just sit if the train ain't moving, I don't sit there. I gotta figure something else out. You know, go to plan B. That's why I have a varied hangar. That's what you need to do. Now, look at this guy. He's got quantum radar, didn't use it, and he stepped out of the circle. He gave me this one. Don't know why, but I know he's got quantum radar. So I don't want to sit here too long, but I don't know. He just sat back and let me grab this one. So that was a nice, easy one. But now, let's get some tactical timing here, guys. He's trying to get it back, but no, he's gonna, I know that, hey, now that we've got this one, we've got the mates that are filing in behind me. They're getting closer and closer. There's that leech that was behind me at the bridge. Now he's moved up. Now we see how we're kind of gaining ground on these guys? So tactical timing. Sometimes you gotta just wait the right thing, but you can't sit too long. You have to be tactical with your timing. If I'd sat in Major Pain for too much longer, it'd have been a bad news. So, hey, the AJ came in here, but now he's got pressure because my men are moving in up behind me here. And look at that. We got the one across the way there, too. We have pushed them now to a big containment zone. Yeah, they're going to get the old Diablo here. He's going to get mech'd out here soon, but that's okay because men are right behind me. That center beacon is flooded with a bunch of blues. So I'm going to go ahead and take, this is Sir Nightmare. He's my Nightingale that I won by filling out a questionnaire a long time ago, and it was kind of a fun little win there. But I don't spend money on this account, guys, and remember, this is the baby account. These are all level 9 weapons and level 6 bots, and I just kind of look for tactical opportunities. Here's a big one here. This guy's walking away. He's trying to help his guys in the center, but in doing so, he wasn't aware of me coming in, and so I'm going to go ahead and grab this one. Again, get us back to a 4-capper, this is going to be a nice, easy one. So now that I've got this one sewed up, and there's a guy that followed me over here, I don't know why, I don't really need to, but that's okay. We have a different angle now on the guys that are spawning in on the red over there, so we really got them pinned down. Yeah, they're going to bring in a Ming or something like that, but it's a little too late, guys. We got this 4-capper. It's going to count down real quick, like we're not even into the time warp yet, and it doesn't really matter. You know, once you get this containment zone, you know, it's a way, you know, you got it locked up. So that was nice. Nice and easy, but you know what? The tactical timing. Sitting there in the beautiful Zeus Fury wouldn't have helped us at all. So I hopped into a quicker bot, one of my other tools, and switched things around a little bit, got some advantage, and then just hung out there until my men could kind of catch on up. great pilots on both sides, masters and experts, and champs too. But if you see your name, thanks for the game. Peace out. I'm going to call this battle Pace, Then Push, and I'll explain why as we go along here, guys. Enjoy my friends in the background and Status as they play their awesome song. November's got a great sound to it, and I'll definitely put a link to their website on the description of this episode. All right, guys, so we're in Carrier now. Now, Carrier is kind of an interesting map because there's a lot of structure, but there's a great Fury sweet spot, and so I'm going to put in my open map deck in here. They've got the one long range bot here, and he can monitor the center. He can obviously guard the beacon right here up on the catwalk, and obviously no one can get behind me until they get past me, so they're all going to be in range. So I'm kind of in range of three beacons, and in fact, depending on where I stand over here, I can even get to the beacon across the way, so I can actually am in range of four beacons. So that definitely qualifies, and so if I can do that, and I can do that for a while, then that makes a lot of sense here. Now, every once in a while, someone's going to come back and threaten. I got to watch my target point here and make sure that I don't get snuffed out too early, but I'm not alone. Obviously, we got people in our area, and you know what I'm trying to do is make sure that we're keeping a beacon advantage for a period of time. Now, if you look at the panicometer, which I always have one eye on the panicometer, that's the part at the top there with the beacon bar and the beacon count and the timer and the head count of how many people are on each side. That's all part of what you need to be watching if you're going to play this game, because this is all part of the game. You got to make sure that as long as you're staying ahead, you know, you don't have to be dominating the entire battle. You just want to make sure that you're staying ahead. And we were up on beacon bar. We were mostly up on beacon count. They were grabbing one back here that I was supposed to be guarding, but that's okay because it was just for a few moments and they got it back. Now they got the center back, and we're going to be digging away at center and chipping away at those guys. Now, I'm calling this battle, you know, Pace, Then Push. And that's what I do with Major Pain here. I'm able to stay here and monitor with three or four beacons, you know, and usually at least three, and hold my own. Now this is, remember guys, I've climbed this, account has climbed to champs. It's level 6 bots and level 9 weapons, far underpowered to be facing these guys. So what do you do? And this is why I'm making these videos, because you know, matchmaking is going to do this to you on a regular basis. It's going to put you in battles that you're not strong enough to maybe withstand, and it doesn't seem fair. Well, look, I put myself intentionally in an unfair position, and yet this account has climbed up. Well, because I've learned a couple things. Number one, when you're in over your head, you want to pace yourself. You don't want to go in pushing and pushing and pushing. You can't, because you just don't have the firepower or the durability to be able to pull that off. So look at Major Pain. We're well over halfway in, and I still have, you know, half my health left. I've been kind of chunking away at the guys. Sure, I'm on a team that's formidable. Well, yeah, when your whole team is outmatched, that's one thing. But we're not talking about a wonky battle. We're just talking about when you kind of got thrown in and you're a little bit over your head. What can you do? Well, you pace. You pace and you pace and you pace, and you keep chipping down the reds. You keep your eye on the panicometer. As long as you guys are ahead, you're good. Now, there's somebody coming back here, and I really can't let him get to that. So I'm going to try to chip him away. This is going to be Major Pain's final attempt. Now, look at that. We're about 6.5 minutes into the battle. Now I'm in my second bot. Guess what? Now I can push. I paced myself to the point where now we've got 3 minutes left, and I can absolutely be reckless with bots, because I've got still, you know, four more bots in the tank, and they're pretty good bots. But now we can go ahead and make that push. You know, now that the Reds are starting to whittle down a little bit, not a lot. They've got one less guy than we do. We have a one-man power play, but we've got the positional advantage, and even though they're going to try to come back and make a little bit of a push, we can just keep pressing and pressing and pressing. You want to pace yourself at the beginning of a battle and just kind of hold out and make sure that you're not falling behind on the panicometer. Keep an eye on those things, you know, and as long as you're not falling behind, then you can, you know, you can kind of weather it for a while, and then you make that push toward the end. Because once you make that big teeter-totter push, they can't say, I'm gonna get burned right here. Who cares? This is, look at this four capper. Look, yeah, burn me down. It's too late, brother. We got this one. That four capper, man, you got it. So guys, when you're in over your head, make sure that you're pacing yourself at the beginning of the battle, and just make sure that you're maintaining along with these whales that you're in battle with. And then, you know, once you kind of get past that first half and you get into that second half, then you can start throwing caution to the wind and lean into the pain and just kind of help bring the green banner home at the end. Great pilots on both sides for sure. And if you see your name, thanks for the game. Peace out. I'm going to call this battle Mad Rush. And man, what a crazy rush here, guys. Enjoy my friends in the background and status as they play their awesome song, War. Perfect for this battle. All right, guys, this is this episode's Beacon Rush battle. I never play it any other way. It is always fast forward every single time. Now, what you do is you open up with your fastest bot, go for the middle neutral beacon, which is what I did with Frick, and then grab it. Then you gotta watch your flanks, though. Don't let them get behind you like these guys are trying to do. They're on the fast forward pace too. And what you gotta do is you get your four capper, and then once you get your four capper, maintain it first. That's the most important thing. If you can get a three capper, I should say, then if you can get a four capper, that's fine. But you gotta watch your flanks. You can't let anyone go past you. You can't let anyone get in your backfield. And you know, if you got a formidable red team, they're gonna be trying that. So always have your eyes on your flank there. Now what's gonna happen? Look at that. Someone's trying to go after our flank, but we got this four capper. We kind of have a containment zone. But you know, we got a formidable red team and they're going after the center there, and now they've got it. So I'm gonna take this is a Sir Nightmare. He's my Nightingale, and I'm gonna go ahead and try to get him over into that center. Guys, I am in level 6 spots and level 9 weapons. This account has climbed into champions. This is no joke. This is not easy. I do not have powerful bots or durable bots, but it doesn't change the tactic that it is needed to win in a beacon rush, and I'm just gonna have to lean into the pain. Sorry about that, Sir Nightmare. We're onto it. Now, that guy's got that one good. Look at Sir Nightmare still shooting into the ground there. But we got a four capper, and that's important. I'm gonna make this a five capper if I can. But you know what? This red team is no joke. They are not sitting back. They are pushing forward. But we have the upper hand, and all we need to do now is try to make this happen. I should have got a little out of that guy's peripheral vision, and I did. Now you got all these reds spawning in here, and that's okay, because now they're all over there. That means the power of the field is split in other areas, and we can hop into the center one here, and I'm gonna take this. This is Buzzkill. He buzzes and he kills you. We still gotta maintain this one. Look at, they're charging in here, so we gotta hold this one. I'll die. I don't care, guys. This is all about leaning into the pain. This is a mad rush. Everyone is just grueling at it. This is so awesome, though, because we're going to take this one. I know we are. You lean into the pain, guys. This is how a beacon rush battle ought to look. You are rushing in. You are making it a mad rush. That guy is going to push me out of the way. I don't care, guy. I'm going to go right behind your back because you have your hands full with my mates. I'm going to get right behind you. I'm going to turn this one blue, and we have a nice four capper, and the game is just about over. We might be close to mecking out, but it don't matter. Guys, you make these beacon rushes a mad rush. You always keep the pressure on. You always lean into the pain. No, I'm not gonna kill a bunch of guys. I have level 9 weapons and level 6 bots. But that doesn't mean I play any different than anyone else. It's always a mad rush. It's always pressing into the pressure. It always is going toward the beacons and making these things a nice green banner at the end, guys. Woo, what a hot one there. That was a mad rush. And if you see your name, thanks for the game. Peace out. Well, friends, that just about wraps it up for another episode. Thanks so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed what you saw and were able to take something you learned and use it in battle. I add content to my YouTube channel on a regular basis, so if you like what you see, please tap on the subscription button and then tap the bell to be notified when new episodes are released. Or just click on an old episode and maybe catch another tip that'll help you up your game. Also, Discord is a great way to connect with other amazing pilots, keep up on the latest news, and learn more ways to improve your gaming experience. Without question, one of the best Discord servers out there is War Robots Master Pilots. Managed by some of the best pilots in the game today, it features a robust list of informational, tutorial, and informative channels to cover anything and everything related to this awesome game. So definitely take a moment to click on the link in the description of this episode and check them out. Finally, my goal is to provide you all with entertaining and helpful information that'll help reduce the frustration and increase the fun. So if you feel these videos are helping you, please share them with a friend, someone you think might benefit from them. Well, that's about it for today, guys. As always, keep them blue out there, and I hope to see you on the battlefield. Just make sure you're having fun, because if you're not, you're doing it wrong. I love you all for your support. Play well. Peace out.